But Trump has clearly used the notion of fake news not to attack real fake news. And it's sort of sad that you have to distinguish between real fake news and only fake news. But Trump, of course, has used it to attack the legitimate press. And he tries to undermine their authority, which I think is a serious threat to our democracy. And to get back to Nazi Germany, one of the first things that the Nazis did in their ascension to power was to denounce the German free press as the Lügenpresse, which means the lying press. And of course, Trump covers all his bases because he also likes to call the press enemies of the people. I just heard him ring off today about some of the enemies. Well, a lot of people use that, but it goes back to ancient Rome. But Joseph Stalin is one of the best known people who had used that. So, you know, the Germans who believed in the Nazis, who bought into the Nazi ideology that they were the wave of the future and they would solve everything, their myth was shattered as soon as the Nazis began losing, and that sort of led to a very fortunate spiral for the rest of the world. I did also want to point out, since it was mentioned, that it was Kamala Harris who, in the second Democratic debate, you know, used science fiction as somehow the opposite of science. And I actually think her, speaking of Barclays, I thought she did great in the debate other than that. But as we intelligentsia here in Readercon all know, science fiction is not the opposite of science. Science fiction actually glorifies science. Science fiction loves science, builds upon science, shows how science can be so useful in exciting adventures. So I do want to get to another question. I don't know how many of you in the audience or on the panel have heard of Phil Ochs, who was, okay, good. Because one of the things, in case you haven't, Phil Ochs, in the opinion of some people, including me, my wife, and many other people, but not probably millions of people, was a singer-songwriter back in the 60s and early 70s. Who in many ways, even though Dylan got all the attention, and Dylan was a great singer-songwriter also, but if you look at the anti-war songs and just the analysis of society of Phil Ochs, he really in many ways was even better than Dylan. So the reason why I just want to mention it now and find out how our panelists feel about this, I think it was 1968. And at the height of the war in Vietnam, when everyone, even just like popular, you know, bubblegum artists were doing, you know, anti-war songs, Ochs came out with an album called Pleasures of the Harbor, in which it was just beautiful poetry, lyricism, songs like The Floods of Florence, and he was criticized for that. Why would you come out with an album of beautiful poetic songs when there's a horrible war going on? And Ochs famously replied that unity is the best response to atrocity and ugliness and everything that this illegal war was bringing us. So it occurred to me that this relates also to the question of how science fiction and science fantasy deals with fascism. Was Phil Ochs right? Is maybe the best thing that we can do as writers is write beautiful stories that bring out the best in human beings, our poetic spirit themselves, and that is the best way of standing up to this Trumpian fascism.